What's good with y'all, man? It's Cam. Bring you another video. Straight like that, dog. Let's get right into it. Comment down below in the comment section what you want to see in the next video. Like the video and subscribe if you brand new to the channel, man. Let's get it, dog. Demon timing as usual, man. Man, it's cold outside, bro. It's dark. It's late, but it's all good, man. I still wanted to bring y'all this topic because it's a very important topic for a lot of y'all, man. Normally, I don't talk about, you know, how to smash first night, stuff like that. I'll be steering clear of these topics because I like to preach to get with high value women. But I'm aware that sometimes y'all just want to have fun and just do your thing, bro. You just want to have fun and do your thing. So this is going to be a step-by-step guide on how to smash the first night, man. So let's get right into it. But before we get into it, there's two prerequisites that I need to go over first, okay? Number one. You need to protect yourself, bruh. When you're doing this, be careful. If you're gonna hit the first night, be careful, dog. You feel me? You need to make sure, because it's dangerous, bruh. You don't know where this chick's been. You don't know. I mean, maybe she's carrying some kind of diseases. Who knows? I'm not saying she will be, but I'm just saying there's potential. You don't know this chick like that. So you must be careful. Make sure that you wrap up. And if you brave and you don't want to do that, if you don't want to wrap up, at least, you know, go to CVS and buy you a, you know what I'm saying, a plan B, whatever the case may be, man. Just be careful, man. I'm not going to encourage any kind of risky behavior, bro. If you are going to be hitting the first night, please, please, please be careful. That's the first prerequisite. The second prerequisite has more to do with a little bit of game, bro. What I need y'all to realize is that there's a common stigma within society that if a girl gives it up the first night, that she is an HOE or belong to the streets, and this is not necessarily true. It could be true, but it's not necessarily true. I need y'all to understand that her interest level is everything. Her interest level in you, right? If her interest level is high, she may just give it up on the first night, bro. Understand that. Listen, women make exceptions for the guys that they're very attracted to. They make exceptions. So this chick may have a rule that she don't get with people the first night. But she may break that rule for a guy that she's very attracted to. Your homies may have smashed the first night. But when it came to you, maybe she wanted to take things slow. The rule then applied to you. Now she want to take things slow. She didn't make that exception for you because she ain't attracted to you like that, bro. It's a hard pill to swallow. But that's just what it is. You know what I'm saying? Not all women are going to have very high interest in you, dog. Like, let me put it like this, bro. Your girl, right? Or a girl you know, whatever the case may be, that you know swears by she don't want to give it up the first night. Put Michael B. Jordan in front of her right now. You think she not folding? She's folding, bro. She's folding. She's folding because they make exceptions for men that they're attracted to, right? And women are, her interest level is going to vary, right? It's based on physical attraction, based on money, status, fame, all that. All of that plays a role in how much interest she has in you, her interest level in you. I've even experienced this, bro. Back in like high school, I remember talking to this chick, bro, and she said that she don't get with dudes the first night, bro. And she told me straight up, except for this one guy. And automatically, I was, oh, man, what you mean except for this one dude? You know what I'm saying? Immediate red flags went off. But anyway, man, so now that we got the prerequisites out of the way, let's get into the game, bro. So you pull up to a party, you pull up to a kickback, you pull up wherever, right? The club, wherever you want to meet, wherever you meet women, whatever scenario you think is best for smashing on the first night, you pull up there. You know what I'm saying? You get there, you see a chick, right? And she look good. She look good. She wearing the right clothes, you know what I'm saying? She look good and everything like that. What I need you to understand is if you think she looks good, there's 10, 20 other guys that also thinks she looks good. You have to understand that, bro. You have to understand that. So knowing that, what does that mean for you? That means that immediately you need to start thinking about ways that you can do the opposite of what everyone else is doing. So let me give you an example. Every guy there that thinks that chick looks good is going to be doing his very, very best in order to impress her. He's going to be doing card tricks. He might even go back to the car and put his best jacket on, right? Even though it's hot inside the party, but he's just trying to flex. Put on a whole puffer jacket, right? He gonna wear the cool gray shoes because he know it's gonna be a chick that look good there. He gonna do everything in his power to try and impress this chick, bro. And you have to do the exact opposite. You do the exact opposite, bro. Instead of trying to grab her attention, Let her chase you. Women love the chase, bro. Let her chase you, dog. So boom, as soon as you get there, right? What should you do, right? Don't look at her. Stop looking. Oh, is she looking at me? Oh, is she looking at me? For one. Number two, just have fun wherever you at, bro. Wherever you at, there's a main objective at a party, whatever the case may be. Have fun with your homies, dog. Just chill. Do you, bro. Don't be so caught up in trying to get this woman's attention, bro. Understand that. Now, I always say wait for choosing signals, right? And you know, people have varying beliefs on whether you should wait for choosing signals or just cold approach a chick. What I need you to understand is that if you cold approach a woman, right? Meaning you approach her without her giving any prior signals of interest, meaning she didn't look at you or nothing like that. She wasn't trying to be in your vicinity, nothing like that. Your chances of smashing the first night drastically decrease. Drastically. Because a cold approach is just that. It's a cold approach. She wasn't even looking your way. Understand that she's going to look. She's going to be showing choosing signals to the guy she's actually interested in. Understand that. So with that being said, if she's not showing you choosing signals when you approach, she was probably showing choosing signals to another dude, had another dude in mind. So now when you make the approach, she's automatically categorizing you as a guy. Oh, here we go again, another guy trying to spit game. She already dismissing you in her mind without you even saying anything yet. That's what happens when you cold approach. You could do that if you want to. I'm just saying that your chances of smashing the first night drastically decrease. So, boom, that's step one. Making sure you're not paying too much attention to her and getting chosen signals. If you don't get chosen signals, I don't know what to tell you. You could try and cold approach, but I recommend you get the chosen signals, right? Meaning that, and what are these chosen signals? Maybe she'll look at you, you know what I'm saying? Be in your vicinity. What she might be walking past you, she brushing on you, she rub on you, whatever the case may be. It's gonna be these subtle signs, bro. It's gonna be subtle signs. You got to pick up on them. You gotta be socially aware. You feel me? You shouldn't be thirsty and looking around. Oh, is she looking at me? But when you see her, right? And if you make eye contact and you could tell she keep making eye contact with you, you got to make the approach. You got to have some kind of confidence and make the approach. That's step number one, bro. Boom. So you get so you get to the point where she's showing you choosing signals. You make the approach now, right? You walking over there. Understand this, dog. What I need you to realize is that when striking up a conversation with a chick, you should never overthink it, bro. I was watching this podcast earlier today, man, and they was talking about, you know, if you overthinking when you approach a chick and you're trying to spark up a conversation, if you overthinking, you overthinking so hard that you forgetting who you even are, bruh. You could be the most interesting dude in the world, but you overthinking it. So because you're overthinking it, now you're like, oh, what do I say? And you coming off of someone that you're not. You're trying extremely hard to be somebody that you're not. Just relax. Be you. You have things to talk about. You've been on this earth for how long, bro? And you mean to tell me you can't spark up a conversation with a chick? What's going on with you, bro? What's going on with you? Now, it's very, very, very key when you approach this woman to not validate her. Do not validate her. Nothing like that. Feel me? Don't go up to her and tell her she beautiful. Her teeth look good. She look good. Every other dude in the party has already done that, and she's already dismissed them, bro. If you want to smash the first night, you feel me? She's already dismissed them. You need to bring up something else, bro. Literally anything else. You could talk about the type of shoes she got on. Maybe she got on the cool grays. Oh, I see you got the cool grays. How you get them cool grays, bro? I was waiting in line. You know what I'm saying? Like, maybe she got a hat on or something like that. Oh, you an Angels hat. Oh, you an Angels fan? Like, just use your environment to your advantage. Use anything to your advantage. Just do not compliment her. In fact, remember that for the whole night. Don't compliment her for the entire night. The entire night. Don't throw her no bone. Don't do nothing like that. Don't do none of that. Keep her chasing you. If you want to smash the first night, she has to be chasing it the entire night. She has to initiate that. Because whether or not she smashes you is mainly, you can run game, but it's mainly dependent on her interest level in you, dog. Now, if she's showing choosing signals, that's a good indicator. So, boom, you made the approach, and now you're talking to her, right? You're talking to her, you're staying calm, and you hold the masculine frame. For those of y'all that don't know what masculine frame is, you're not jittery, you're not nervous, whatever, calm body language, right? It's also called seduction. You call it seduction mode or whatever the case, whatever, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's basically just when you relax, you feel me? You're relaxed, you're calm, you're just talking to her. You're having a good time, whatever. You're chopping it up, dog. Understand that if she has very, very high interest in you, right? she will probably, she may even ask for your number, right? But what she's going to do is she's going to steer the conversation to a point where it's like, you almost have to ask, like, oh, like, what's your number, or, you know, or what's your Instagram, or whatever the case may be. You feel me? It's going to get to that point. It's going to get to that point. I mean, it's going to get there regardless, but she going to do it. You know what I'm saying? Depending on her interest level, you know what I'm saying? She may do it off rip. She may do it after a while. You feel me? It all depends, bro. But as you're talking to her, and once you get to that point, you know what I'm saying? You exchange socials, but that's not important because you worried about smashing the first night, dog. So you can go ahead and give her your Instagram or your number or your Snapchat. This is about how to hit the first night. So that does not matter. That's a video for another time. That's how to, you know, capitalize and just step down. You feel me? But if you're trying to hit the first night, that doesn't matter. However, it is important to gauge interest. You feel me? If you exchange socials, you know for a fact that there's some level of interest, right? Boom. After that, leave her alone for a bit. Leave her alone for a while, right? You in the party, let her be, and do not show her attention. You're gonna have to talk to her at some point. You're gonna have to talk to her later. However, for a while, whatever, leave her alone. Why? The biggest mistake that a lot of guys keep doing is they keep on talking. They keep on talking, and they talk themselves out of a situation that could have potentially been great for them, bro. Stop talking, bruh. First of all, while you're having the conversation, you need to make sure that you're listening to what she's saying. She'll even give you clues on what to talk about sometimes. But listening is like 80% of seduction, bro. If you listen to what she say, bruh, you're going to pick up on a lot of things. You're going to pick up on a lot of clues, pick up on the type of person she is, her interest in you. You feel me? And you're making eye contact, bruh. Oh, my God. Bro, if you make eye contact, bro, understand that her interest level is going to go way. If two dudes do the exact same thing and get choosing signals and they have the exact same conversation with a chick, except one made eye contact and one didn't, the one that made eye contact is probably going to smash the first night. That is a very, very big thing. It portrays confidence, right? And make her feel, it gave her that, you give it off a masculine vibe, bro. She getting that masculine vibe from you when you staring, you looking in her eyes, whatever, you know what I'm saying? She getting that masculine vibe, you feel me? You know what I'm saying? That's gonna make her more attracted to you already, boom. After y'all had that conversation, boom, you stop talking to her for a little bit. You go out in the party, you do your thing, bro. You do your thing, blah, 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 blah. Now, one of two things is going to happen. Number one, if she has enough interest in you, she may even go up to you and spark up another conversation, right? Number one. Number two, she may show you choosing signals again, right? Regardless, you are going to have a conversation with her later in the night. But please do not try to talk to her the whole entire night, bruh. If you happen to come across her, cool. But do not force it. Do not force it. Don't be one of those dudes that gets with the chick and then like kind of gatekeeps her. You know what I'm saying? And it's just talking to her the whole entire night. You ain't got to do all that. If it happens, if y'all just in that deep of a conversation, all right, fine. I'll let it rock. But don't force it. Please do not force it. So, boom, you having fun, whatever the case may be, you at the party, boom, whatever, 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 an hour or two passes, or some time passes, you're not trying to, you know what I mean, you're not trying to do too much. Now, whether she sparks up the conversation, or you got to spark up the conversation, right? And I said, like I said, don't force it, keep it natural, you know what I'm saying? So, like, let's say you run into her again, it's time for the second conversation. Now, this second conversation is not anything to be afraid of. It's not anything to be afraid of, right? Now, as you're talking to her, right, you need to get the logistics out the way. Because if you're going to smash the first night, the logistics and everything have to be in order, right? Why? Because let's say that she's just in town for the party. She's going to go right back home after the party, you know what I'm saying? So you need to ask things such as, you know what I'm saying, oh, you from around here, whatever the case may be. This second conversation should just be that, or a continuation of whatever your first conversation was, or whatever the case may be. Now, if you didn't do it in the first conversation, this second conversation is key. This is where you need to start making your move. This is where the smashing actually begins. Why? Touch barrier, touch barrier, touch barrier, seduction, touch barrier, bro. You need to break the touch barrier on the second conversation, bro. If not the first, then the second. Why? Because if you need to hurry up. This is on one night. You know what I'm saying? You're trying to do this all in one night. Now, how do you break the touch barrier? You got to keep it simple. You feel me? So when you go up to her, when you're talking, how about you say something like, hey, let's go somewhere where we could talk. Or let's go somewhere a little bit quieter where we could talk, whatever the case may be. So you out there, right? Boom. So, and you know what? I just thought about this too. I just thought about this to myself. I know a lot of y'all is going to be like, well, why do we got to talk to her the first time and then leave her and then talk to her the second time? Well, That's because you never want to come across as the guy that's trying to be desperate, and you never want to come across as the try hard type dude. So, you know what I mean? If that conversation naturally dies, right? If it just fizzes out, whatever the case may be, don't try and keep it going. You know what I'm saying? Take a break and start a second one. But like I said, if the first one just flows, and just have one convo, right? It's not that important. But anyway, you talking to her. You have to break the touch barrier, bro. Let's go outside. Let's go somewhere a little bit more quiet. Whatever, man. Y'all talking. You feel me? Get close to her. Boom. You close to her. You know what I'm saying? You brush your hand on hers, whatever the case may be. You know what I'm saying? You can even be bold. Put your arm around. You know what I'm saying? Put your arm around her waist. Something like that. You talking to her. You know what I'm saying? Blah, 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 blah. I guarantee that if you break the touch barrier, I'm not going to get way, way too graphic into detail. You feel me? But if you break the touch barrier, the conversation is going to get to a point where you already know what's going down, bro. You feel me? It's going to get to that point. It's going to get to the point where y'all talking about, oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. I just live around the corner. You feel me? I got a couple of roommates, but you know they ain't in the room with you. You feel me? Like, how about I? You know what I'm saying? Like, I could show you. I could give you a little room tour. You feel me? It's something as simple as that. Room tour, bro. I could tell y'all, man. I remember back in like what was it? Freshman year of college, bro. Man, my boy, bro. My dog was spamming that, bro. He was always like, oh yeah, yeah. Like, let me give you a room tour. Let me give you a room tour. Whatever the case may be, man. And that may sound like it's corny or whatever the case may be, but understand that if her interest is high enough anyway, it doesn't really matter what you say, it's just how you say it. You know what I'm saying? It's just how you say things. You can't just be straight up and be like, oh, let's do this. You know what I'm saying? You gotta beat around the bush a little bit. You gotta be more indirect. Right? Because that's how women are. They're indirect. So you got to be indirect when you come, when you spit in game and stuff like this. You know what I'm saying? Oh, how about I give you a little bit of room tour? Or, you know what I'm saying? Oh, I just, you know what I'm saying? I just moved in recently. You know what I'm saying? Let me show you around. Or, you know what I'm saying? Maybe you go to her place, whatever the case may be. Oh, you got a crib? Oh, yeah, where you staying? You know what I'm saying? Like, whatever it is, bro. Now, some chicks may be skeptical because, you know, they don't like bringing dudes that they just met or whatever the case may be. But like I said, bro, if her interest level is that high, then it ain't gonna be that difficult. It ain't gonna be that difficult. This conversation won't be that hard. If she will make it very easy for you, if she's into you like that, dog. Now, like I said, you breaking the touch barrier and you're continuing to escalate. Now, what I need y'all to realize is that once you get to that point where the touch barrier is broken, y'all been close, you know what I'm saying? Y'all, you been in seduction mode, you know what I'm saying? You talking about, you know what I'm saying, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, oh, yeah, you're like, how about you slide through the crib? Whatever the case is. Once you get to that point, you cannot then go back to the party. And don't do that thing where, like, you escalated and then you stop talking to her. Like, you go somewhere and then you stop talking to her and then you try to come back again. Don't do that. Don't do that. It's two conversations max. Like I said, the first conversation is you acting on the twos and signals. Maybe y'all exchange socials or whatever the case may be. And then there's the optional second conversation, right? And that space in between, see, because the reason that space in between, right, is so important between that first and second conversation is because when you leave that space in between, it's going to show her that you're not actually trying to, you know what I mean, try too hard and gain her attention like every other guy is. You feel me? You showing her, yeah, I could go without. I could, you know what I'm saying? It's a take it or leave it mentality. It is, like, you know what I'm saying, it is what it is. Like, I don't really care. You feel me? Once you show her that, bro, I guarantee her interest, boom, through the roof, G. So, boom, you've already broke touch barrier and everything. Do not disengage in the conversation at that point, because if you're going to smash the first night, it has to be at that point. Oh, let me give you a room tour. Oh yeah, like, you know what I'm saying? Oh, you got a car? Yeah, I got a car. Like, let's go. You know what I'm saying? You exit the party. You have to exit the party or exit wherever you're at that time. Why y'all having the conversation? Do not leave after you escalate and then try to come back and be like, oh, yo, let's go. Because I guarantee what's gonna happen is this. You're gonna go off, right? And whatever happens is gonna happen. She might talk to some of the dudes or whatever the case may be. She might talk to her homegirls. Her homegirls is gonna be C blocking, you know what I'm saying? Other dudes gonna be C blocking, you feel me? And then you're going to try and come back, and then you're going to try to re-spark the escalation, and it's already going to be, the spark is already going to be dying down, bro. The flames is already going to be dying down by that point. You got to do it while you in conversation, bro. So boom, take her back to the crib, and then the rest is going to be history. You feel me? The rest is history. The rest is history. Now, what I want y'all to understand is, what I want y'all to notice is that there was no particular special thing about anything that I just said. There was no special thing that you had to say. There was no special tactic that you had to use. They were very basic and simple tactics. Why? Because most of it is based off of her interest level in you, first of all. And second of all, your confidence level is going to determine how well this goes, right? So acting on choosing signals takes confidence, right? The confidence to hold a conversation with a chick and hold eye contact, that takes confidence, right? The confidence to break the touch barrier. You have to have the confidence to do all these things. And once you have that confidence, and if her interest level is high and those two combine, it's going to be very easy for you to smash the first night, bro. It's going to be extremely easy for you. It's going to be extremely easy. It's not a very difficult thing to do. In fact, like the thing is this. This is the summary of everything I just said. If you have to raise her interest level by doing something crazy, wazoo, if you have to convince her to let you smash the first night, you're not gonna smash the first night. It's something that she's already made up in her mind the moment she first saw you, the first 10 seconds she's seen you. That's why it's very important to hold masculine frame at all times. That's why it's very important to always be confident in yourself. You feel me? See, because the talking to her part, understand, that's not about raising interest. That's just about escalation. You're never going to, listen, it doesn't matter what you say to the chick. It's your actions that's going to raise her interest, right? Talking to her, just the conversations is just for the escalation part. It's just for the escalation part and, you know what I'm saying, getting comfortable with each other, whatever the case may be. But she's already, understand, women already done made up in their mind within the first 10 seconds of seeing you whether she's going to smash or not and whether it's going to be on the first night or not. First 10, 20 seconds. That's why they're very, very vital and very, very important, bro. Right? So when you're walking up to her, boom. When you're walking up to her, you feel me? Make sure that you look confident. You feel me? That's why I say wait for choosing signals, too. Choosing signals are a very clear indication. Like, dang, she might want to, you know what I'm saying? Choosing signals is very important. All of that. Acting on the fact, if you don't act on the choosing signal, she automatically, oh, never mind. He don't have the confidence to do it. You feel me? But most of it is something that you can't even control. Most of it is just her interest in you. And a lot of it is going to be physical. You feel me? Or if you got some kind of notoriety or and people know you or something like that, bro. But anyway, man, I hope you enjoyed that video on how to smash the very first night. You feel me? Yeah, man, that's how to smash the first night, bro. You feel me? And understand, too, like I said, bro, be careful. You don't know this chick like that. But, you know, be careful. Have fun. Do you, man. Love y'all. I'm out of here, dog. Peace.